Hello everyone, it's Sagasibat here. Are you interested in launching the next distributed application on top of Hedera Hashgraph? Well, if you are, I had the chance to sit down with Jordan Free, the head of business development from Swrilds, the Hashgraph company, in order to find out more.
What we hope to achieve, what our vision is that Hedera as a platform is self-service. You actually don't have to talk to anybody to use the platform. There's no license required. The code base is completely transparent, open review for with version one of the platform. And what we're building is a suite of self-serving tools and resources to be able to create an account on the platform once we release the testnet to the market, and to be able to start making API calls to the network using the native platform token. So let's call it the Gossip Guy DApp.
Yeah.
So Gossip Guy wants to build a distributed application on top of Hashgraph. What you want to do is you want to reach out to any member of our business development or developer advocacy team. We're all very approachable, either in our Telegram community, on Discord. You can send an email to info@hashgraph.com or partners@hashgraph.com. What you do is you send a query. Someone from our team will help push you in the direction of a project consultant. Then what we do is we start a discovery process. You tell us what you want to build, and we help put you in touch with legal if you need to talk to legal, or developers if you need to talk to developers, or a system integration company or a development firm if you need to get your project built. Or if you have your own internal dev team, we'll help them better understand the development framework so that they can start coding their application immediately. In some cases, for projects we're really interested in, we can even make introductions to the marketplace at large, to other strategic partners that these applications or your DApp is interested in working or collaborating with. So we have a growing ecosystem. I'd also say that the community has been a huge support to those interested in building DApps, and our Discord community is a great place to start to better understand the code base and how to build on it. Yeah, so you can come with simply an idea. The more farther along you are, I think the more helpful we can be. So if you're at the stage where everything's really theoretical and you don't yet know what you're going to build, this can cause I would say, misdirection, or we may not be able to support you, as well as if you already know exactly what you want to build, you have it spec'd out or wireframed, and you're ready to start the development process either with your own internal devs or you need an introduction to someone that knows how to develop for Hashgraph. We have a growing channel of partners, including big four consultancies and even boutique system integration companies, solutions providers that can build on Hashgraph. They can do POCs in 90 to 100 days in most cases. So you should come, I would say, at the minimum with an idea, but the more you have, the better. So if it's a permissioned application that's going to use Swrilds technology, we already have an SDK that's public. It's being updated regularly. That's for Hashgraph consensus. In the not too distant future, we intend to release more of a full stack there, where you'll have application layer plugins, and we'll talk more about that probably in a later video. You'll be able to have smart contracts and other things in a permission setting. That's the vision, at least. What we're doing at Hedera is we're slowly releasing our testnet to a wider audience. And over the coming weeks, I suspect this will be published very shortly, so I would tell you in May, June, and July, we intend to open up our testnet to developers at hackathons and start to release the services layer, so micropayments, distributed file store APIs, and smart contracts through the Solidity scripting language, and release that to developers so that they would all have this code base to build on top of. That's not available today. Over the next few weeks, that will change. Yeah, so literally we're exposing a set of public APIs. So the public APIs you can connect to either through a REST API to execute a Solidity smart contract, or you could run just in a native mobile application, for example. It will also function as an SDK if you just want to see the code base. Again, the intent is that for it to be completely transparent with version 1. Nothing will be hidden. There's no centralized nodes there that we're afraid to show. So I'd say we're very proud of it. We think micropayments, distributed file store, and smart contracts are a great starting point for an application layer or a services layer. And we've also said that there's probably more services to come. For example, our distributed file store now has a revocation service with it, which is really, it's a big deal, because for identity applications or to be in compliance with GDPR, you may want to revoke something that is deemed no longer necessary to have in a ledger. Even like this late in the game, where we've been doing this for a while now, we've had thousands of conversations with brilliant teams all over the world, I'm still hearing new distributed ledger use cases. And that really keeps me going. So anyone here that's interested, I'm actually going to make it a point to come back and talk to all of you. If you have comments or questions, I will be watching. If you want to be critical, that's fine too. But let me know if you have comments or questions, and I'll come back to this video and I'll do my best to answer them and have people from our team answer them. My email is jordan@hashgraph.com or jordan@swrilds.com. You can even tweet at me on Twitter @JordanFried. And I'd love to talk about what you're passionate about and what your use cases are. It's all interesting for us.
So there you have it, folks. Everything you need to know in order to launch an app on top of Hedera Hashgraph. So everything that Jordan covered, I've left links to all of it down below. And also, let me know what you think about this video by leaving a comment. This is the Gossip Guy, signing out. Thanks for watching.